Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic which stands one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Call the meeting to order at 6:00 PM. Can I get a roll call, please?
Michael Cashman.
Present.
Thomas Wood.
Here.
Barbara Hebert.
Here.
Charles Kostick.
Here.
Dana Isabella.
Here.
James Coffey.
Here.
And Catherine Calucci is present.
Perfect. I'm going to take Chairman's prerogative just for a moment before we begin, because that is a new roster this evening. And I want to welcome our newest colleague to the town board. We are very, very excited to work with you, Dana. I know that you will contribute immensely to the growth and wealth and health and well-being of the town during your term. So welcome to the town board.
Thank you.
Also want to acknowledge some other elected officials, but in particular, new to his role officially is Dave Zio, is a newest representative as county legislator, representing actually the largest section of the town of Plattsburgh. But Wendell Hughes is also a legislator that represents a portion of the town. So good to have both of you gentlemen here today. And welcome and congratulations back to both of the colleague, Barb Hebert and Katie Calucci, and taking their seats again in the new term. So Resolution 1, approve the minutes of the previous meeting.
Resolve that the minutes of December 2nd and 9th of 2021 be approved and the reading of the minutes be dispensed with.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
I'm going to give it to Wood on that one. Wood, Kostick, is there any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 I'm going to call it again. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
So carries. Thank you. With the mask, it's a little bit harder, so I just want to make sure. Resolution 02, supervisor retain the original of all correspondence.
Resolve that supervisor be authorized to retain the original of correspondence he receives and file photocopies with the town clerk.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Kostick, is there a second?
Second.
Wood, any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
So does Carrie. Resolution 3, supervisor shall act as chief financial officer for the town of Plattsburgh.
Resolve that supervisor Michael S. Cashman as the chief fiscal officer for the year 2022 be authorized and directed to deposit idle money into interest-bearing accounts or to purchase certificates of deposit from any town funds, including special districts in the Adirondack Bank, Key Bank of New York, TD Bank, Glens Falls National Bank and Trust Company, Champlain National Bank, MBT Bank, NYC LASS, Jeffries LLC, Harborside Financial, Piper Sandler and Co., or Community Bank pursuant to Section 64, Subdivision 1 of Town Law. Be further resolved that general highway and special district funds be deposited in checking accounts with the aforementioned banks with offices located in the town of Plattsburgh for the year 2022, or any other bank that provides necessary collateral as required by audit and control. And be further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the finance manager.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Hebert, Wood, any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Resolution carries. Just want to go back. Is there anyone seeking to provide comment this evening from the public? Didn't see any intention before. Just wanted to make sure. Once, always moving forward.
Always good.
Resolution 04, authorized to pay public utility service claims.
Resolve that pursuant to Section 118 of the Town Law, the supervisor be authorized to pay claims for public utility services, electric, gas, water, sewer, fuel, oil and telephone, postage, freight and express charges before they are audited. And be further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the finance manager.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Kostick, Wood, any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
So does Carrie. Resolution 05, supervisor shall be in charge of all special districts.
Resolve that supervisor Michael S. Cashman and in his absence, deputy supervisor shall be in charge of all special districts, which includes water, sewer, ambulance, stormwater management district, consolidated highway district and lighting district pursuant to Section 29 of Town Law.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Hebert, Wood, any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
So does Carrie. Resolution 06, Town Board Meetings for 2022.
Resolved that the regular monthly and semi-monthly meetings of the Town Board be held on the first and third Thursday respectively of each month at 6:00 PM prevailing time in the Town Hall of the Town of Plattsburgh at 151 Pinker Road, Plattsburgh, New York. And it is further resolved that informal work session meetings of the Town Board shall be held on the second and fourth Thursday of each month at 6:00 PM prevailing time in the Town Hall of the Town of Plattsburgh at 151 Pinker Road, Plattsburgh, New York, pursuant to Section 62 of Town Law. And it is further resolved that on occasion, the Town Board will meet 15 minutes earlier to distribute material to the councilors and prepare for the meeting. And it is further resolved, in the event that there is a fifth Monday in any month, meetings will be scheduled at the discretion of the supervisor. And be it further resolved that due to holidays and conflicts, the Town Board does hereby change the dates of its respective scheduled meetings as follows, canceling Thursday, November 24th of 2022.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Wood, is there a second?
Second.
Kostic, the only additional item for discussion that I would just provide, because it comes up usually sometime throughout the year, December tends to be one of those months that as we continue to proceed and people may be traveling for the holidays and stuff, that our last meeting of the year can be a week or two before, like, the end of the year. So just keep that in mind, that it's on the calendar, and then we address it appropriately as we get a little bit closer. Okay? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Resolution carries. Resolution 07, Salary and Payday for Elected and Appointed Officials.
Resolved that pursuant to Section 27 of the Town Law, all elected and appointed officials shall be paid bi-weekly on Wednesday, beginning January 5th, 2022, with the exception of the town attorney, councilors, historians, and town justices, who will be paid on the last payroll of each month. And be it further resolved that the salaries of all elected and appointed officials be fixed as indicated by the approved budget for 2022, and a copy of this resolution be given to the finance manager.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Kostic, is there a second?
Second.
Isabella. Is there any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Resolution 08, Petty Cash for Town Officials.
Resolved that pursuant to Section 64 of Town Law, petty cash funds be established for town officials for 2022 as follows. Finance manager, 100. The town clerk, 200. Receiver of taxes and assessments, 400. The town justices, 100 each. And it is further resolved, a copy of this resolution be given to the finance manager.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Hebert, is there a second?
Second.
Kostic, any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
So does Carrie. Resolution 09, Travel Policy Revision.
Whereas the Town of Plattsburgh has adopted a travel policy last updated on 2015, and wishes to update the current policy to comply with the current law and regulations. And whereas it is as indicated by the attached draft policy, the Town Board has reviewed the existing policy and recommends that revisions be made. Therefore be it resolved that effective this date, the Town of Plattsburgh's travel policy be revised effective immediately. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution and the attached revised policy be provided to update the official town's policy books, and a copy be given to all department heads and the finance manager.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Kostic, is there a second?
Second.
Wood, any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
So does Carrie. Resolution 10, Purchase and Procedures for Goods and Services.
Resolved that the Town of Plattsburgh adopted procedures for policies as indicated by the town's official policy book shall be the procedures to be followed by all elected and appointed officials and town employees for the year 2022. For the purchase of commodities, equipment, or goods for public works, projects, contracts, for professional services and consultants for purchase order policy and cash disbursement procedures. And it is further resolved that the Town Board does authorize and order that the purchase order policy and cash disbursement procedures as outlined in Schedules A, B, C, and D shall become the policy and procedures to be followed by town and Plattsburgh personnel for purchase orders and cash disbursements for the year 2022. And it is further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the finance manager.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Wood, is there a second?
Second.
Isabella, any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Resolution carries. Resolution 11, Investment Policy.
Resolved that the attached Town of Plattsburgh 2022 Investment Policy be and the same hereby is approved effective this date, and the supervisor is authorized and directed to implement the same for for the town, and to schedule an annual review of said policy by the town board audit committee for the purpose of reviewing and recommending to the town board any amendments thereto. And be further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the finance manager.
Motion?
So moved.
Hebert, is there a second?
Second.
Kostic, any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
I'm going to call it again. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Carries, thank you. Resolution 12, naming of the official town newspaper.
Resolved that pursuant to section 64 of town law, the Press Republican be named as the official newspaper for the town of Plattsburgh.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Isabella, is there a second?
Second.
Wood, any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Resolution does carry. Resolution 13, resolution authorizing supervisor to enter into an agreement with James J. Coffey Esquire to provide legal services.
Whereas the town board of the town of Plattsburgh wishes to retain the services of James J. Coffey Esquire as an independent contractor that is an appointed official to provide legal services on behalf of the town. Whereas James J. Coffey Esquire has offered to provide legal services to the town, whereas the town desires to retain James J. Coffey to perform these legal services. Now therefore be it, the town board of the town of Plattsburgh in regular session duly convened does hereby authorize the supervisor to execute the attached agreement with James J. Coffey Esquire to furnish and perform legal services for the town, which are the subject of the attached agreement. Two, for the above services as outlined, the attorney will submit an appropriate voucher to the town for audit and payment of the legal services rendered during the prior month. Three, James J. Coffey Esquire will be entitled to protection under the public official's liability policy of the town. And four, this resolution shall take effect immediately.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Hebert, is there a second?
Second.
Kostic, any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Resolution carries.
Welcome back, Jim.
Yeah.
Thank you. Resolution 14, appointment of a fair housing officer.
Whereas the Office of Fair Housing and Equal Opportunity administers federal laws and established national policies to assure that all Americans have equal access to the housing of their choice. And whereas the town of Plattsburgh wishes to have an officer who will implement and enforce the Fair Housing Act. And whereas the supervisor on behalf of the town board recommends the appointment of Steve Einhoff as the Fair Housing Officer for the town of Plattsburgh to serve at the pleasure of the supervisor and the town board. Therefore, be resolved that Steve Einhoff be assigned to oversee that fair housing regulations are followed and act as the primary point of contact for all fair housing related issues. And be it further resolved that Mr. Einhoff take an oath of office within 30 days of his appointment, and a copy of this resolution be given to the finance manager, the LDC board, and a copy be placed in the personnel file.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Kostic, is there a second?
Second.
Isabella, thank you. Any discussion? Seeing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
So is carried. Resolution 15, committee appointments for 2022.
Resolved that the councilors Barbara Hebert and Dana Isabella be appointed to serve on the assessing, planning, and zoning committees for the year 2022. This committee shall assist with rezoning, updating zoning, and matters concerning assessing. And it's further resolved that councilors Barbara Hebert and Dana Isabella appointed to the auditing committees for the year 2022. This committee shall examine all vouchers presented to the town board for payment. And it's further resolved that councilor Barbara Hebert be appointed to serve on the finance committee for the year 2022 and is to report to the town supervisor and town board its findings. It is further resolved that councilors Chuck Kostic and Dana Isabella be appointed to serve on the buildings and grounds committees for the year 2022. This committee shall make reports and recommendations on all town buildings and properties, including special districts. It is further resolved that councilors Chuck Kostic and Barbara Hebert be appointed to serve on the community services and ambulance committees for the year 2022. This committee shall concern itself in the liaison and cooperation with municipalities and ambulance service providers in the matters of joint service issue that may be presented to the town board. It is further resolved that councilors Tom Wood and Dana Isabella be appointed to serve on the highway committee for the year 2022. This committee is to observe the conditions of all highway equipment, road signs, and town highways, and therefore report to the town superintendent of highways and to the town board on said conditions and recommendations. It is further resolved that councilors Tom Wood and Dana Isabella be appointed to serve on the Justice Court Committee for the year 2022. This committee shall advise the office and staff and make report of conditions and recommendations to the town board. It's further resolved that Councilors Chuck Kostic and Barbara Hebert be appointed to serve on the Personnel Committee for the year 2022. This committee shall advise the the office staff and make a report of conditions and recommendations to the town board. It's resolved that Councilors Chuck Kostic and Tom Wood be appointed to serve on the safety committee for the year 2022. This committee shall review all reported employee accidents, preside over employee safety meetings, and make reports and recommendations to the town board. It's further resolved that Councilors Barb Heber and Tom Wood be appointed to serve on the tax receiver town clerk committee for the year 2022. This committee shall advise the office staff and make a report of conditions and recommendations to the town board. It's further resolved that Councilors Tom Wood and Chuck Kostic be appointed to serve on the water and wastewater committee for the year 2022. This committee shall inspect the water and sewer facilities and make a report of conditions and recommendations to the water and wastewater director and the town board. It is further resolved that Councilors Chuck Kostic and Dana Isabella be appointed to serve on the youth services and recreation committee for the year 2022. This committee shall advise the youth services and recreation director and make a report of conditions and recommendations to the town board.
Is there a motion?
So it's just 30 seconds.
So moved.
Kostic, is there a second?
Seconded.
Ebert. The only thing I will provide for this is from time to time, we have seen committees shift at a later point in a year. So that has happened from time to time, doesn't always happen, but I think it's worth noting that sometimes things need to be recalibrated. So with nothing further, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Resolution does carry. Thank you very much. Resolution 16, Fire District Liaison for 2022.
Whereas the town board of the town of Plattsburgh desires to maintain effective communications with the various fire districts and volunteer fire departments situated within the town of Plattsburgh and provide to each fire district and department a town board member as liaison. Now, therefore, be it resolved that Councilor Barbara E. Huber, who is appointed to serve as a town liaison with the Fire District Number 3 and District Number 3 Fire Department. And it is further resolved that Councilor Dana M. Isabella be appointed to serve as a town liaison with the Katyville Fire District and Katyville Fire Department. It's further resolved that Councilor Thomas E. Wood be appointed to serve as a town liaison with the Morrisonville Fire Department and Morrisonville Fire District, and Morrisonville Fire Department. It's further resolved that Councilor Charles A. Kostic be appointed to serve as a town liaison with the South Plattsburgh Fire District and South Plattsburgh Fire Department. It is further resolved that Supervisor Michael S. Cashman be appointed to serve as a town liaison with the Cumberland Head Fire District and Cumberland Head Fire Department. It is further resolved that the liaison write a letter to each district and department advising each of their appointment and offering their assistance as town board member for the year 2022.
Before I ask for a motion, I'm going to make just one modification. We had talked about this last year. It just was not reflected that the resolve that the liaison just provide outreach to the district and the department. A lot of people have said just over the years that the letter, by the time the letter got there, that they had already talked sometimes two or three times in previous years, so just outreach occurred. So, is there a motion?
So moved.
Kostic, is there a second?
Second.
Isabella, any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Resolution carries. Resolution 17, Municipal Property and Liability Insurance Renewal.
Whereas it is necessary for the town of Plattsburgh to provide risk management services and municipal property and liability insurance, therefore be it resolved that their supervisor is hereby authorized to renew its agreement with the Gallagher Insurance Agency, principally located at 2 Country Club Road, Suite 1, in Queensbury, New York, to provide risk management services, and is insurance broker for the town to provide municipal insurance coverage. Be further resolved that after careful review of the town's needs and market options, the town board wishes to renew property and liability insurance for the period January 10th, 2022 to January 10th. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. Shall be provided by NYMIR reciprocal endorsements as warranted during said period. Be further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the finance manager and the supervisor, be authorized to sign all related documentation with NYMIR and Gallagher and Co.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Kostic, is there a second?
Second.
Wood, any discussion? Seeing none. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Resolution carries. Thank you. Resolution 18, the abstract.
Resolve that the abstract audited claims number 22A-2021 for $605,594.02. Abstract 22-1A prepays for 2021 in the amount of $260,592.55. And number 22-1A for $62,974.79. Abstract 22-1A prepays for the amount of $337,398.46. Be received as reviewed by the audit committee, and the supervisor is hereby authorized to pay said abstract.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Heber, is there a second?
Second.
Wood, any discussion?
I just want to offer my thanks to my colleague, Chuck Plattsburgh. Great joint discussions regarding our audit committee involvement and great attention to detail, Chuck, so appreciate that.
I'm glad, more than happy to turn over to Dan.
Something that turns.
COVID-19, by the way, was challenging at times, Michael, you know.
I do?
The last couple of years have been a tough one.
Yeah, so again, thank you, Chuck.
Yeah, thank you, Mark.
You gave me the energy to continue.
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Resolution carries. Resolution 19, Regal Cinemas license application.
For its compliance with town Plattsburgh codes and zoning laws, Regal Cinemas has applied for a license to conduct and operate a cinema known as Regal Cinemas, located in Champlain Center North in the town of Plattsburgh. And whereas said application was applied for and received with a license fee of $500, and whereas the codes department has completed their inspection and has found Regal Cinemas to be in compliance with all local laws and New York State regulations and codes, therefore be resolved to receive and place on file an application for a license to conduct and operate Regal Cinemas. It is further resolved that the town clerk is hereby authorized to issue said license for the period from January 1st, 2022 through January 31st, 2022.
Is there a motion?
No.
Isabella, is there a second?
Second.
Constick, any discussion? Seeing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Resolution carries. Resolution 20, JCO Services Agreement.
Whereas the town of Plattsburgh Town Board is in receipt of the 2022-2021 annual agreement between the town of Plattsburgh and the Joint Council for Economic Opportunity of Plattsburgh and Clinton County Incorporated, which states the services and financial assistance rendered by both parties for the operation of the community outreach program in their town of Plattsburgh, in the town of Plattsburgh, for the period commencing January 1st, 2022 and ending December 31st, 2022. And whereas the town board has given consideration to the request of $21,123 for the contribution for the outreach program, and hereby does authorize the supervisor to sign and execute said agreement upon approval by the town attorney. Therefore be resolved that the supervisor is hereby authorized to make payment in the net amount of $21,123 to JCEO, and that payment be made payable from the town of Plattsburgh General Fund. It is further resolved that an executed copy of this agreement is returned to JCEO for their files, and a finance manager also be given a copy.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Heber, is there a second?
Second.
I'm going to give it to Constick. Any discussion?
Is this payment made in one lump sum, not the two installments?
If I remember correctly, and I just don't recall off the top of my head, I think it's in a couple of installments.
Question.
The party of the second part agrees to provide the party of the first part of the sum equal of one half. Yeah, that's in two.
Okay.
Yep.
Thank you.
Any further discussion? Seeing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
So does carry. Resolution 21. Former County Airport, three parcel zoning map ordinance amendment and seeker review for 2022. Do you want to take a deep breath?
Sure.
Namaste?
Namaste. Oh, all right. Whereas after thorough consideration and deliberation, the town board proposes to make the following amendment to the town zoning map and ordinance. One, the town board act to amend the town zoning map for portions of tax map parcel 220.13.1-1, as shown on the planning board approved subdivision sketch plan on October 19, 2021, specifically changing the area of proposed lots B, D, and G from AD-TB
on the attached planning board map amendment recommendation. And two, the town board act to amend portions of the zoning ordinance relative to the special district. Specifically, it is recommended that front yard parking be allowed at the discretion of the planning board upon the provision of adequate screening and landscaping by the applicant. It is further recommended that the landscaping requirement of the special district be amended to allow uses such as parking other than green space and landscaping. And the special, number three, the special district be amended to allow site lighting with a maximum height of 35 feet, similar to that allowed in other districts of the town. And that four, that the town board schedule a public hearing on the above zoning ordinance and zoning map amendments in accordance with zoning ordinance article, which one is that? Let's see here. What's like 17?
17.
And amendment section 17.4A. And that the town board refer this zoning map amendment petition to the Clinton County Planning Board in accordance with GML 239M and town zoning ordinance article 17, section 17.4B. And that the town board comply with the provisions of Article 8 of the Environmental Conservation Law, Part 617 NYCRR, SECRA, prior to rendering its decision. And seven, whereas the town board previously adopted Resolution Number 021-56 at its regular meeting held September 2nd, 2021, and pursuant to Zoning Ordinance Article 17, Section 17.3 referred their motion to the planning board of the town of Plattsburgh for report and recommendation in accordance with said section. And whereas the town board is in receipt of the planning board findings and recommendations report adopted at a meeting held on November 16, 2021, in accordance with zoning ordinance section 17-2, or .2 rather, and 17.3, and which said resolution found based on a finding and recommendations report of the planning board dated November 10, 2021, that the town board consider the following. One, that the town board act to amend the town zoning map for portions of tax map parcel 220.1-3.1-1 as shown on the planning board approved subdivision sketch plan on October 19, 2021. Specifically changing the area of proposed lots B, D, and G from AD-TB and AD-MU to SD, and as more clearly shown on the attached planning board map amendment recommendation. And two, the town board act to amend portions of the zoning ordinance relative to the special district. Specifically, it is recommended that front yard parking be allowed at the discretion of the planning board upon the provision of adequate screening and landscaping by the applicant. It is further recommended that the landscaping requirement of the special district be amended to allow uses such as parking other than green space and landscaping. And the special district be amended to allow site lighting with a maximum height of 35 feet, similar to that allowed in other districts of the town. And that four, the town board declined to amend the special district to allow front yard loading dock services areas. And five, town board declined to amend the special district increasing the maximum building height from 40 to 60 feet. And six, that the town board schedule a public hearing on the above zoning ordinance and zoning map amendments in accordance with zoning ordinance article 17, amendment section 17.4A, and that the town board refer the zoning map amendment petition to the Clinton County Planning Board in accordance with GML 239M and town zoning ordinance article 17, section 17.4B, and that the town board comply with the provisions of article 8 of the Environmental Conservation Law, part 617 NYCRR, SECRA, prior to rendering its decision. And nine, whereas the Clinton County Planning Board was provided a copy of the proposed zoning map amendment and findings and recommendations report of the planning board dated November 10, 2021, and did by a 7-0 vote on December 1st, 2021, approve the general municipal law section 239-M referral with comments provided. Said comments were reviewed, considered, placed on file, and of no significant environmental impact. For this zoning ordinance map amendment, and be further resolved that the notice of no significant environmental impact and all related materials shall be maintained on file at the town offices of the town board and available for public inspection. And the reasons for the decision are stated in the attached negative declaration. Be further resolved that the zoning ordinance of the town of Plattsburgh be amended as follows. One, within the special district SD, front yard parking shall be allowed at discretion of the planning board upon the provision of adequate additional landscaping. And three, the special district be amended to allow site lighting with a maximum height of 35 feet, similar to that allowed in other districts of the town. Be further resolved that the zoning map of the town of Plattsburgh be amended as follows. One, town zoning map for portions of tax map parcel 220-1-3.1-1, as shown on planning board, approved subdivision sketch plan on October 19, 2021, specifically changing the area of proposed lots B, D, and G from AD-TB and AD-NU to SD. And as were clearly shown on the planning board map amendment recommendation contained in the report of the planning board dated November 10, 2021, be it further resolved that said amendments be entered in the minutes of the meeting of the town board of the town of Plattsburgh held on the 6th day of January 2022. Be it further resolved in accordance with section 264 and 265 of town law, a copy summary or abstract of the amendments, exclusive of any map, shall be published in the Press Republican, a newspaper published in the town, and that of affidavits of publication, therefore, shall be filed with the town clerk. And be it further resolved that the amendment shall be effective as provided by and in accordance with section 265 of the town law. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the town clerk, zoning department, and the planning department.
This is one of those ones that does not happen very often, so it's very mechanical in nature. Is there a motion to this resolution?
So moved.
Costa, is there a second?
Second.
Hebert, any discussion? Seeing any discussion? Yeah?
SECR, was that completed? Because it says that we have, but the SECR that I have, there's many blanks, and it's not complete as far as I'm concerned.
It has been completed based upon the material that was getting population from what Trevor had done for that particular item.
Yep. So the rest of it would get completed?
There's other elements. This is kind of like chapter one of this process. There's still more things to do as it's been articulated in the resolution.
Yeah. I didn't find that complete.
Yeah.
Yep. I have some general statements of concerns that I have. In this particular instance, it's 477 acres, and 28% of the land is they want us to rezone right now. And we've already rezoned land for a building for Norsk, which is basically empty. And I'm not totally confident that the way it's been going through the county and the county administrator, that they take into account these types of things. These businesses are paid for, subsidized by the public, by public money from the state, and by pilots, which does not help the local area. We have, in the course of time, we've had comp plans. We've developed comprehensive land use plans. We have developed smart growth plan. We have developed recreation plans. We have developed each of these things. The zoning follows that. I don't like the fact that we create zoning and then switch it all the time. Particularly when all of a sudden, we need to have these projects done. We need to have this done. I understand that as a new entity comes in to develop land, that they have to be considered, and that they may ask for variances, or they may ask for a change. And we have done quite a bit for IDA to change land property, for instance, for Nova Bus and areas like that in the past. But I don't see this whole property, 477 acres, being given up to development for businesses and manufacturing and corporations, and particularly for storage units and for distribution centers. It is studies and articles that I've read show that the best use of the land, the best return is from the building of homes where people live there and they work and they have small businesses, and that's where we get our long-term things. The companies that come in and build these buildings like Norse have plenty of money and they don't need to keep them open. We will end up sort of like we complained about in the past with the city and the town of buildings that are not usable, housing, etc., that are vacant, just deteriorate and become an eyesore and a danger. And that's what I'm concerned about with these types of things. Under the present zoning, some of this is allowed already. Changing it to SD would, in one instance, make it easier for us to control how the place was developed, how it would be developed. So even though I have these considerations here, and I'm adamant about these types of things, Also, the lighting. I have advocated for night lighting for the town of Plattsburgh since I started on the town board. I still do. I don't feel this is going to be night lighting. Most of the lighting I see around the town does go out and lights up other areas, not just the area that people are supposed to be working in. So I do have those concerns, and I trust the fact that our planning board and our employees have done a good job of going through this, but I would inspect very closely anything that comes back to us for changing zoning, etc. I was under the impression this was going to be tabled tonight, and I will allow it to go through. I'm not going to block it here. I just want you to know that. I think that that's a heck of a lot of land to change just like that when we have a smart growth plan that we have finished and just need to adopt in another week or two, and that we need the zoning to go with that. And that should be done before we have anybody else come in. So those are some of the comments I have. I've gone through a whole lot of things, and most of the things I have are philosophical about how I think this area should develop, the town should develop, and what's best for the town. In this case, I'm going to set that aside for this particular one.
Thank you. Any other comments or discussion? Any other comments or discussion? Seeing nothing further, at this point, given the magnitude of, what it is, I'm going to ask for a roll call vote.
Thomas Wood?
Yes.
Barbara Hebert?
Yes.
Charles Kostick?
Yes.
Dana Isabella?
Yes.
And Michael Cashman?
Yes. Resolution does carry. Thank you very much. Let me just get this back organized a little bit here.
Letter of resignation?
Yeah. Resolution 22, letter of resignation from Youth and Recreation Director.
Whereas Ms. Melanie Defiant has submitted a letter of retirement from her position of Youth and Recreation Director effective March 8th of 2022. Therefore, be it resolved, the Town Plattsburgh Town Board has appreciation for her prior years of service in that position, accept Ms. Defiant's letter of retirement as Youth and Recreation Director, and wish her well with her future endeavors. Be further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the finance manager and be put in her personnel file.
Is there a motion?
So moved. If we could just change the header from resignation to retirement.
Okay. Yep. Is there a second?
Seconded.
Hebert? Just want to read short excerpt from Mel's letter. This letter serves as my notice to you of my intention to retire from employment at the town of Plattsburgh after 33 years of serving the public in the town of Plattsburgh's Park and Recreation Department, with her last day being March 7th. I'm grateful for the support of the town boards I have provided this department over the years. It has enabled us to expand the opportunities for our residents to enjoy new programs and add sustainable amenities to the park. I would respond to Mel's own comments that we are very fortunate to have had her in a distinguished leadership position for such a long time, and her passion, dedication, and innovation in many regards have served the residents and the region very, very well. And I think we're fortunate to still have a little longer with her to make a smooth transition. So we will not say goodbye yet, but we will say a heartfelt thank you. So.
Yes.
I agree, and my first contact really with anybody from the town of Plattsburgh was with Mel Defiant when she was program coordinator, probably some 20 plus years ago. So, she did a heck of a job then.
Very, very dedicated.
Heck of a job now, and it's going to be some tough shoes to fill, but certainly, I know that she's ready.
Yeah, and I echo that, Chuck, their department has had to be, I guess the word I'd like to use is agile. Has to be very agile during the last 2 years of reinventing some things, being creative and continuing quality of life in our Plattsburgh.
Yeah, and I'd like to say, I believe that she's quite excited about the fact that she's going to retire and she's go canoeing and doing that whenever she wants.
She is.
With nothing further, can I get a roll call vote, please?
Thomas Wood?
Yes.
Barbara Hebert?
Yes.
Charles Prostick?
Yes.
Gina Isabella?
Yes.
And Michael Cashman?
Resolution does carry. Resolution 23, reappointment of Robert Miller to the Assessment Board of Review.
Whereas Mr. Robert Miller, resident of the town of Plattsburgh, is willing to serve as a member of the Assessment Board of Review. Therefore be it resolved that the town board does hereby reappoint Mr. Miller to the Assessment Board of Review for a 5-year term to expire September 30th of 2026. Be further resolved that Mr. Miller take an oath of office within 30 days of this resolution. And be further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the board chairperson and Brian Dowling, town assessor.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Hebert, is there a second?
Second.
Wood, any discussion?
Just want to thank.
Go ahead, Bob. Go ahead.
Just want to thank Bob because he's been on the Board of Assessment Review for quite a long time.
Especially after the last year.
Yes, I was just going to say they worked very hard during the townwide reevaluation process. So thank you, Bob, and the rest of the Board of Assessment Review Committee.
I really appreciate that he's willing to continue in a time of need when we are short-handed.
Yeah.
And he's done a good job all the time.
Okay. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Resolution does carry. There's no additional resolutions to be considered this evening. However, I know of a need for a brief executive session with no action, formal action to be taken this evening, but the topics to be certiorari regarding Champlain Center Mall, KeyBank, and the discussion of the work history of four individuals. Is there a motion going to executive session?
So moved.
Motion by Kostick. Is there a second?
Second.
Hebert, can I get a roll call?
Thomas Wood?
Yes.
Barbara Hebert?
Yes.
Charles Prostick?
Yes.
Dana Isabella?
Yes.
Michael Cashman?
Yes, we will officially enter executive session at 6:48 p.m. Thank you very much, folks. Again, no formal action to be taken from executive session. That's just a draft for next week.
So what's new?
Not too much, you.
No good?
Yeah, it's as good as it's going to get.
Dave, how's it going?